identify the side of the given moon. The given moon is right-sided figure. Mention 2 points of for identification.
Hadiya.
Head faces upwards, middle, and slightly forwards. And the long axis of the shaft is directly parallel and radial. The given moon is left-sided figure. Name the parts of the given moon. The parts are the head, neck, greater trochanter, lesser trochanter, shaft, epicondyles, and condyles. Describe the anatomical position. Keep the bone vertically in such a way so that the head faces upwards, medially, and slightly forwards. The long axis of the shaft is directed downwards and medially. The given bone is right-sided femur. Describe the borders and surfaces on the greater trochanter. It has one border, that is upper border, and three surfaces. Anterior surface, medial surface, and lateral surface. Describe the attachments on the colored part. On the anterior aspect, it is attached to piriformis, and on the upper body, it is attached to gluteus medius. The given moon is right-sided femur. Identify the colored part of the bone. The colored part of the bone is lesser trochanter. Name its attachments. The attachments are psoas region on the upper part, and in the middle, iliacus, and in the lower part, it is attached to pectoralis. The given moon is right-sided femur. Name the mark area. The mark area is trochanter fossa. Name its attachments. The attachments is operator externus.
Right.
The given bone is right sided femur. Identify the features of middle one third of the shaft. It has three borders and three surfaces. They are posterior border, medial border, lateral border, and three surfaces. Anterior surface, medial surface, lateral surface. It has a ridge called linea aspera where muscles are attached. Name the muscles attached on the linea aspera.
From medial to lateral.
From medial to lateral is adductor brevis, adductor longus, adductor magnus, vastus medialis, short head of biceps femoris, lateral intermuscular septum, posterior intermuscular septum, vastus lateralis. The given bone is left-sided femur. Identify the colored part of the bone. The colored part of the bone is gluteal tuberosity. Name its attachment. The attachment is gluteus maximus. The given bone is left-sided femur. Mark the capsular attachment of the hip joint in the upper end and knee joint in the lower end. In the upper end, capsule is attached anteriorly to intertrochanteric line, posteriorly to middle of neck, so that the medial half of the posterior surface of the neck becomes intracapsular.
Start.
At the lower end, capsule is attached to posteriorly to intercondylar line and articular margins. Laterally and medially to align 1 cm above the articular margins. Groove for popliteus is intracapsular. The given bone is right sided femur. Identify the colored part of the bone, red and blue. The blue colored part is adductor tubercle. The pink colored part is lateral epicondyle and groove for tendon of popliteus. Attachments of adductor tubercle are adductor magnus and for lateral epicondyle
gastrocnemius
muscle
popliteus,
and for groove It is popliteus muscle.
हाँ.
Describe the association of nerve.
Primary center.
One center appears for shaft at the 8th week of intrauterine life. Second centers. 4 in all. 3 for upper end and 1 for lower end. Upper end. In the head. It appears at first year. In at the greater trochanter. In the third year. In lesser trochanter. At the 13th year. Fusion. There will be epiphyses which fuse with shaft separately at 18th year. Lower end. Appearance. 9th month of intrauterine life. That is at the day of birth. Fusion at 20 years. Mention the medical legal importance of lower end of femur. The lower end of femur appears at the day of birth, that is after 9 months of intrauterine life. So it is helpful in finding out whether the baby is premature or not. Name the commonest site of fracture of femur. Below 16 years, the shaft is the commonest site of fracture. And after 60 years, the neck is the commonest site of fracture. Identify the given bone. The given bone is patella. It is also known as kneecap. Name its peculiarities. It is a sesamoid bone developing in the tendon of quadriceps. It is the largest sesamoid bone in the body. It is situated in front of the lower end of femur, about 1 cm above the knee joint line. It participates in the formation of knee joint. It improves the leverage of quadriceps femoris by increasing the angulation of the line of pull of legs. It lacks periosteum, therefore patellectomy is often a choice of treatment for fracture of patella, as there is no chance for regeneration. Removal of patella does not hamper the movements. The given bones are right-sided patella. Name is attachments. The superior border or base provides insertion to rectus femoris in front and to vastus intermedius behind. The lateral border provides insertion to vastus lateralis in its upper one third or half. The medial one third provides insertion to vastus medialis in the upper two thirds. The non-articular area on the posterior surface,
ligamentum patellae,
provides attachment to ligamentum patellae below and is related to extrapatellar pad of fat above. The quadriceps femoris muscle is inserted into patella from where ligamentum patellae arises, which ends into the tibial tuberosity.